الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise is due to Allah, and His praise and blessings and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad and the rest of the messengers and the prophets and their followers until the day of judgment. My dear brothers and sisters, we are pleased to bring you another episode of The Robe That Binds Us, As-Sunnah waljama'aah. Last episode, we were talking about the definition of al-bid'ah. But we did not finish talking about the whole definition. I remember we were talking about that bid'ah, which is related to the religion. It was something invented in the religion. So it's a religious matter. It's not related to the worldly matter. So nobody can say, for example, this laptop is a bid'ah. You cannot read Quran from it. Or somebody say, I heard just recently an imam masjid was almost fired from his position because he used laptop instead of using the paper that regular people use to give the khutbah or read the notes for khutbah from. He put his laptop in the minbar and he was addressing the people and reading from his laptop. They fire him because they said this is bid'ah. That has nothing to do with the religion. This is just related to the worldly. It's a worldly matter. How to write it, how to display the information, also the video, this pointer, and so on. So, which is things related to the worldly matter, there is no bid'ah in it. Bid'ah is related only to the things which is related to in the religion. So it's a religious matters. Then the second condition, after the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if there is something was invented by one of the Sahaba or started by one of the Sahaba during the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam time, it will not be considered bid'ah. It will not be considered bid'ah because it's either something the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam approved, so it became sunnah. Or the Prophet ﷺ disapproved and the Prophet ﷺ stopped people from doing it, so it will not be allowed to be, it will be something forbidden or not recommended, so we cannot do it. Anyway, it will not be part of the bid'ah, the religious innovation. Then here, the definition goes, by adding or leaving an act which has no foundation. Let's see first. Adding or leaving. Bid'ah can be by adding something to the religion, adding something to the religion, or leaving something from the religion. Some people think that bid'ah is only by adding something to the religion, but it could be the other way around. Leaving something from the religion, or leaving something religiously, if we can say that, it will be considered a bid'ah. For instance, and sometime in the history of Islam, some people said, we will never drink cold water. And they worship Allah with that. They want to please Allah by not drinking a cold water. One of the scholars of hadith asked the person who said that, why you will not drink cold water? He said, because it's a great ni'mah, it's one of Allah's bounty on us, and the cold water is something I cannot thank Allah enough for it. Then that scholar said, have you thanked Allah enough for what have He blessed you with from your eyes, your nose, your heart, your head, and all these things that you already thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enough for it? To avoid or say, I'm not going to drink water, cold water? So this is became a bid'ah. Also, by adding something to the religion, somebody will add a new prayer or a new dhikr, a new supplication, and he will add this to the Raj. He said, okay, part of the salat to add this or that. Let's add to the adhan, like so common in some countries. After the adhan finish, they will add to it, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. They will add the salat on the Prophet ﷺ and his family. It's not part of the adhan. The Prophet ﷺ, when he taught the Sahaba how to call for the prayer, which we call the adhan, he never add these additions to it that people practicing today, or some people practicing today. So it's either by adding or leaving, by adding or leaving something from the religion, or leaving something even if it's not from the religion, but he will avoid it religiously just to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it. Let me just ask, maybe we can raise this question. What if somebody start wearing thick clothes? We say if he wear thick clothes because it's cold, it's winter, we say it's okay because this is worldly issues. But if he start wearing wool and thick clothes because he think that wool, suf, is something very special and it will make you closer to Allah, and as much as you wear old clothes and thick clothes, it make you more righteous, more accepted, and your prayer will be more accepted by Allah, or something like that from this nature. Now he start wearing this religiously, he start avoiding other type of clothes religiously, and here it became bid'ah. Here it became bid'ah. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, when he saw a woman, she promised or she made an oath that she will perform the Hajj without being in the shade. She will always stay in the sun. The Prophet ﷺ said to her, don't do that. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu ardhah also saw a woman or a man who promised that he will never be in the shade, he will never sit, he will be always standing until he finished the Hajj. Abu Bakr said, this is not allowed. And he said, stay in the shade, sit and walk. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, a woman once took an oath and she said, I will never talk. Yani, I will abstain from talking to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that. See, she avoided something here, which is talking. By the way, abstain from talking is a form of fasting for the nations before us. But it's not allowed in our religion. We know the Prophet Zakaria, Maryam alayhi salam, Mary, she promised or she made an oath that she will not talk for 3 days and nights. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the Quran about them. But in our religion, it's not allowed. That's why when Abu Bakr also saw a woman who said she will not talk, he said, this is not allowed in our religion. This is forbidden in our religion, to fast or to abstain from talking at all for a day or in a way to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. This is not the way we fast as Muslim. Anyway, so leaving an act which has no foundation in religion or in a manner which has no base in the religion. What's the difference between these two? And this is very, very important. Sometimes what people add or leave, something has no basis in religion at all. There's no foundation for this matter in religion at all. Such as some people celebrating, for instance, the birthday of the Prophet ﷺ, or the birthday of so-and-so companions, or one of the Prophet's wife. Somebody's going to celebrate the birthday of Khadija, birthday of Aisha, or the birthday of Khalid ibn al-Walid. He said, this is the day we're going to make Mawlid, they said, and celebrating, and it will be a specific occasion that we do certain act of worship. This has no basis in religion. There is nothing in religion related to this issue. So it's a pure innovation. It's a pure innovation in religion. Also, some people, what they invented religion, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with things also has no basis in religion, like some sect, they start worshiping Allah by dancing and by music. They play music they dance and they jump up and down, and they said, this is the way we perform our ibadah, or we worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this way. This has no basis in religion. And this became an innovation. They call it an original innovation. Aw bid'ah asli. Sometimes it has a base in religion. It has a base in religion. But the manners, the way they perform this bid'ah, it's not from the religion. For instance, by adding certain conditions, certain times, or or doing it in a certain ways which is not from the religion. Let's give an example. If somebody said, I want to do a 5 rak'ah every day after Asr. Praying has base. It's good to pray. The Prophet ﷺ said, pray as much as you make prayer, as much you raise your status in Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to perform the prayer, Nusalli. So if somebody said, I want to invent 5 rak'ahs every day after Asr, it became innovation because 5 and after Asr, putting this time, putting this number of rak'ahs, or the way he performed the prayer, if he make his own performance, 3 ruku', 3 sujoods, things like that, it will become an innovation because the manner he practiced that act of worship, it's not from the religion. So it's either has no foundation or at all, or maybe it has base in religion, but the way he performed it is not from the religion. Most of the innovations from the second group of, or the second part, we call that an additional innovation, bid'ah idhafiyya. And we'll talk about it maybe a little bit more in future. Okay, the reason, and this now the last condition, the reason for this act was present at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and any hindrance was absent. Listen carefully. So the reason for this act was exist in the Prophet ﷺ, was there, and there is no hindrance prevented the Prophet ﷺ from doing it. There is nothing prevented the Prophet ﷺ from doing it. I give you an example. If somebody today said, I give you a real example, happened in the history of Islam. That one of Bani Umayyah's kings or caliphs decided to change the way people perform Eid prayer. He said, I will make the khutbah before the salat because I want everybody to attend the khutbah. Because after the salat al-Eid finished, everybody leave and nobody listened to him when he addressed the community. So he said, I'm going to switch. I'm going to put the khutbah before the salat, and it's for the benefit of the Muslim that they listen to the khutbah, attend the dua, and so on. This has become an act of bid'ah innovation and not accepted. And the scholar said, it's not allowed. Why? Because this reason, which is attending to the khutbah, benefiting from the khutbah, that's why he invented that act, was exist in the Prophet ﷺ time. And there is nothing prevented the Prophet ﷺ from doing that. That's why it became an innovation. Also, another example. If somebody said, people go back home now after Asr or before Asr and they are so sleepy. Let's add to the Asr prayer, As-salatu khayrun min an-nawm. Let's add to the Salat, the Asr Adhan, when they call the adhan for the Asr prayer, let's add as-salatu khayrun min an-nawm. It will be permissible? No. It's an act of innovation and it's not acceptable. Anyway, unfortunately, again, the time is up and we must end here. And inshallah, we'll continue our discussion in the next episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.